Today, I'm going to show you how to use a multimeter. The multimeter is probably one of the most important tools in an electrical engineer's toolbox. This is because it allows us to see many various values in our circuit. And today, I'm going to show you how we can use it to measure resistance, capacitance, AC voltage, DC voltage, as well as use the continuity meter in order to see what is connected to what in our circuit, which is very useful for troubleshooting circuits. To use a multimeter, we're going to need two things: the multimeter itself, and some probes that we can probe our circuit with. Starting at the top, we have the display, and this is where we're going to see the values that we measure in our circuit. Below that, we have the dial, and this is where we're going to select the function of the multimeter that we want to use. At the bottom, we have terminals, which is where we're going to be plugging our probes into. First, let's go ahead and learn how to measure a DC voltage. In this circuit, I have a box here, which is acting as the power supply, which is feeding a voltage across this resistor. Let's say that we want to measure this voltage. To do that, we first need to connect our probes to our multimeter. We're going to take the black probe and connect it to the common terminal, and this is also known as the ground. Next, we need to find the terminal that has a V on it. This will tell us where we need to plug our red probe into. Next, we need to select the DC voltage function on our multimeter. To do this, we're going to turn this dial until we have the V with the line and the dotted line above it selected, and this stands for DC voltage. With our probes in hand, we're going to very carefully make the first connection on one side of the resistor by pressing it against an exposed metal part, and we're going to do it with the other side. And as we can see, we have a 2.9, essentially a 3-volt voltage across this resistor. Now it's time to look at how to measure an AC voltage. This box is now generating an AC voltage. To measure this AC signal, we're going to want to make sure that our probes are plugged in to the same place as when we are measuring a DC voltage, and we're going to want to select the V with the squiggly line above it. That stands for AC voltage. Next, we're going to probe our circuit once again. As we can see, there are 0.7 volts across this resistor, but because we're measuring an AC voltage, in the upper left-hand corner, we can see that it is actually a 1 kilohertz frequency. Next, it's time to learn how to measure resistance. To measure resistance, the first thing we need to do is always double-check where our probes are plugged in, and since we are plugged in to where it says ohms, we're good to go measuring resistance. Next, we need to select ohms on our multimeter, so we're going to turn the dial until we have the ohms selected. Let's say we want to measure the resistance of this bottom resistor. You might be inclined to just go ahead and probe on either side of this resistor, and we will see that it's 164 ohms. But this would be incorrect because this resistor is in our circuit, and as we can see, this very simple circuit has two resistors in parallel. So we weren't measuring the resistance of this one resistor, but rather both of the resistors in parallel. And we do not want to do this because it will give us the incorrect value. The easiest way to measure the resistance of just the resistor is to make sure it's pulled out of our circuit, and we can put it down here somewhere that where it's not connected. And then we can then probe either side of the resistor to see that this was a 0.3 kiloohm or 300, basically a 330 ohm resistor. Now let's look at how to measure capacitance values. For capacitance, once again, we want to make sure our probes are plugged into the correct terminal. The black one is in our common, and our little capacitance icon there is where our red probe is plugged into. So now let's go ahead and select the capacitance on our multimeter. For me, I'm going to turn it to where we were measuring ohms, and then I'm going to hit the select button until the capacitor option is enabled. I know that because it says nanofarads, which is a measure of capacitance. I have two capacitors here that I do not know the values of, so I'm just going to stick them in my breadboard. And we can now use our probes on either side, and we can see that this is a 104 nanofarad capacitor. And this one here is a 2.6 nanofarad capacitor. Once again, like we had with resistors, if we were to have these in parallel, I'm just going to stick them both in the same row so they're in parallel, and I measure the resistance across here. We are now measuring the parallel capacitance. Now let's use the continuity checker to see what's connected to what in our spaghetti circuit. One very useful feature that most multimeters has is a continuity checker, and this is going to give us a beeping noise if something is connected to something else. And this lends itself to be very useful when we have sort of a spaghetti circuit like this and we're wondering if this hidden capacitor here is electrically connected to this one down here. We could follow every single possible connection, but we can use our multimeter just to probe the two leads and see if they are connected indeed. First, we need to make sure our probes are connected to the proper terminals. The black always goes to the common ground, and the red is going to be in the same port where we did our resistance measurement. Now to get to the continuity mode, once again, I'm going to turn the dial until we get to where we measured ohms. And for me, I'm going to press it to the little audio icon shows up here. And now if we were to take our two probes and touch them together to make connection, our multimeter will give us a beep sound, letting us know that those are connected. Now we can probe our circuit to see if any two things are connected. So we can probe here and probe here, that is not. If I probe over here, that is connected. Lastly, let's take a look at how to measure the current that is flowing through our circuit. Lastly, we're going to jump back to our resistor connected to a power supply circuit in order to measure the current that is flowing through the resistor. In order to measure the current has to flow through the multimeter as well, then connect back to the circuit, or else we can't measure it. And for multimeters, this is going to be a separate terminal. And we can see we have a 10 amp terminal and a milliamp terminal. And this is going to be dependent on what range of values you need to measure. And we need to be very careful about this because we can see that they are fused. And if we connect it to the wrong one, we could blow the fuse in our multimeter and would have to replace it later or else it won't work for current anymore. And we also need to be very, very, very careful that we don't try to measure voltage when one of our probes is plugged into these two terminals, because we would instantly short out our circuit because these are connected internally. So for me, I know that this is going to be in the milliamp range, so I am going to unplug it from voltage and plug it into milliamps. If you are not sure what range you're going to be in, it's always best practice to start with the highest fused one and then work your way down. Since I'm measuring milliamps, I'm going to turn my dial to select the milliamp range here. And now we need to insert our probes into our circuit. So we need the current to flow from here, flow through the resistor, and then before connecting to ground, we need to run it through the red probe, through our multimeter, back out to the black probe. I just noticed I accidentally selected amps before, so I went ahead and I changed that to milliamps. Okay, now we're going to make this connection. And I'm going to use my finger to hold the ground to the black probe, and I'm going to probe the other end of the resistor. And we can see that there is 9 milliamps flowing through this resistor. And I'm able to touch this probe like this because there's very low voltage. This is a low voltage circuit. If you were doing a higher voltage application, you would not want to touch the circuit. If you like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up. And don't forget to check out our other videos on electronics. As always, if you have a suggestion, leave it in the comments below, and I will see you next time.